Hey guys, in this video we're going to make a map by using telemap editor. So let's start. Okay, so let's do some level designing. So first thing, for level design we're going to use the telemap system. So let's create a tile padlet. So Windows, 2D and tile padlets. After going to tile padlets, create a new padlet and name this anything you want, tiles, and let's create it. Create a new folder so we can store all the tiles here. Tile map and select folder. Then we need to drag and drop the tiles here. So let's go to tiles. And now I'm going to drag and drop all the those tiles that we're going to need. So first tiles are like this one. So let's drag and drop these tiles. Tile map select folder. Okay, so we got this tile here. So I added all the tiles that are we going to need for this level. You can add more if you want in the further way further. So for now just all these tiles we needed. Now main thing for creating tile map, we need first have a tile map in the game of tile map game object in the editor. So let's first hide this player for now. Let's create right click here and create a tile map here, right side map. Now when you create tile map, so go to grid and tile map, so we can get multiple tile maps again. So first tile map will be responsible for have all the ground tiles. So I'm going to separate all the tiles in different game objects, like ground have all the ground, some trees and some water and fences, different. Okay. So this way you can manage all the tiles easily. So let's increase the order layer by 2. This is going to be the most above tile, and let's create duplicate this tile. Okay, so triple D. Let's create 4. So next thing, we have a tile called fence. This is going to 1. This will be 3 and grasses. Let's make it 1. And this one is going to be a part of our water. Let's make it 1. So we have a 3 tiles at the same level, and this ground tile have a highest order layer. So now let's add a tile map collider to the our ground one, so we can easily interact, so we easily collide with them, so they can stand on the ground. And next thing, we see ground tile will going to be a walkable, so let's give a layer ground so we can also walk on it. Now let's go to tile padlets, and now we start, we can effect select any tile and going to select the brush one, and start we're going to start just dragging the brush and clicking, and it's going to start making pad tiles. So, and there are a bunch of features you can look on, and you can erase them by using the erase tool. Let's first erase all of them. We're going to start, let's make up some better tiles here. Also going to hide the tiles. So first thing, I'm going to create all the ground one. Okay, like if I'm going to drag and drop like this somewhat here, I'm going to select this one. I'm going to some drag here. Okay, then select this here. Like something this. Okay, now if you look, I created the one basic structure of the levels. It's not a good, I know, but for now this, so I'm not good at level designing. So before, and next thing, I'm going to one more thing, like if I want to draw some tree and fences, so I can select the fence one, and what I'm going to do, I just started drawing all of this like this. I also going to create a symbol for the player where to go. So Now let's get some bench fence. Also, let's draw some trees. So here's the one small structure of the level. Let's start playing this game and let's look how it's going to look. So okay, we got a okay. Let's first enable the player. Also, let's drag and drop somewhat up here. Okay, next thing we I forgot disable tile map colliders in my mistake, I think. Now we can stand on the ground and we can start walking around. So let's start walking around and look, so we can jump. Okay, I think I just make the player jump, but that's more powerful. Here's the movement strip. Let's make it jump by 15 and minus 55. Okay, now let's explore. So we can walk around. Walk around. Okay, now we have a so our level is looking good. Now one more thing, like we did a level here. Now I one more thing, like if I jump in the water, so we can just fall down. So I want to make the player just die when they touch the water, something like that. So it's pretty easy. Now we're going to go to our water. We have a water in a different one. So let's add a timer collider to him too. And this time we're going to make his trigger. Also let's add a tag of water and save it. And let's assign this tag to the here simply. And if we are going to the Visual Studio in the player health one. Now we can directly kill it, or we can add knockback, anything. Works. I'm thinking of directly killing him is a much better. So control C and let's type if do the same thing. And this time I'm going to make it water. And instead of doing all of this, we just going to sequentially we're going to make from health points. We're going to health points or simply at simply destroy this game mode directly. For now, this is game object. Okay, one more thing, like this will not gonna work. Because our we have using a trigger and we're using this function collider. So okay, now let's do this with Go plus X, okay, now. Now this is going to work. Now let's try this. Playing. Okay, now let's jump in the directly in the water. So what will happen? Okay, the player will die. Now also you can add some knockback. If you're going to do the same here like we did control plus X, control plus C, and if I'm going to try the knockback function one, and now if I let's also try the knockback, what happens? Now if I directly jump, so I get knockback. So it's really depend on you what if you directly want to kill it or give it knock some kind of knockback. And next thing, because so if you satisfy with level, we can start drag and drop our AI. So if you look, we have our AI and we simply started drag and drop this AI directly in the scene. So what I'm going to do, let's drag this one somewhat here, let's this one here. Also let's make it character order in layer by 5, so it's from the front of everyone. Next thing, just drag and drop somewhat here. Now let's suggest this point A and point B. Let's make point A or somewhat here and point B somewhat here. Now let's check this is it working or not of the AI. So okay, now AI is now right working, right? Let's kill him. So like this, you can drag and drop enemies and create some bunch of levers in your game for your game. And now if you have done with the level 1, if you want to create level 2, it's pretty easy. Now let's save this first scene here. Now let's save this scene, save as, go to scene folder and we keep, let's leave it 1, stand for level 1. So we have one level. Now go to new scene. So we got a new scene right here. Okay. And I'm going to file and save this scene as a second. Now then I can simply start creating this scene. If I go to 2D object, and we're going to add a tile map. Now in this tile map, we can simply start adding some tiles. So it's really depend on you how you're going to make your own level, and that first level goes just for demonstration purpose, and create a bunch of levels for UI using tile map editor. That's it for this video. In our next video, we're going to look on the scene management, in which we're going to look how you can make a play menu and also going over screens and try to connect all the different level scene together, so we can make a game just where the player win the game. It's just going to proceed to the level 2. So thanks for watching, and if you really like this video, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss the next upcoming video. So till then, bye.